If I seem a little worried, I am. The urgency is now intense. 24th of September, it's now been shown that this is the crucial date. This is why that big, huge Jesus balloon over Melbourne, Australia had a number 24 on it, and then it tied in with the World Cup, and Bad Moon Rising was the rising of ISIS. They have a flag with a white moon on it. 24th is when the president chairs the Security Council, and they're going to pass, I believe they will pass, a resolution. The resolution is a binding resolution for all 192 members of the UN to block all transit of people, all recruiting within their countries for any sort of terrorist activity. Of course, they've already labeled a lot of the Christian right groups, the militia groups, patriot groups, all the various things like as terrorist groups. See, this is very important. So this is the beginning of this new phase, and it's really the dividing point. So last night I was shown a dream. The whole thing was laid out in this dream. What is going to happen? First of all, they are definitely going to work to confiscate guns. There's no question about it. We are headed for a police state. The police, I saw the police coming in, and they are searching everywhere for guns. Secondly, I saw the police attacking white people. I imagine they're the Christian right, and wiping them out. And then, as I was leaving this world, there was this huge black tower up on the, and this on the top of the black tower was the media, and they were broadcasting, and they said, "Hey, Ross, where are you going? What time is it?" They said, "What time is it?" And I looked at my watch, and it says, it's one something. And then the watch, then I said, "Wait a minute." The world was all waiting for like the Super Bowl to start, some big contest. And I said, "Wait, it hasn't started yet. So how can, maybe this is not right." And I look at my watch, and the watch was fluctuating the time. It says 12:31. I said, "What's going on? This is supposed to be synced to satellites. Are the satellites not working?" There's a big confusion coming up here. Then as I walk along a path, I saw all these wildcats, different types of leopards and pumas and panthers and tigers. And, you know, I said, "Whoa, they're all in front of me." And we were confronted with these. And someone who was walking with me said, "Hey, stand to the side, let them pass." And they were all coming into the world. All these wildcats are coming into the world. It is going to be a very nasty time in the world. We have been warned that these times are coming. The evening of the 24th is the Feast of Trumpets in 2014. We have been warned that this is the time where the separation will begin. And as the dream showed me, no question, that what we people have been concerned about is certainly on its way. This UN resolution can be easily expanded to include, all you have to be is your group labeled terrorist organization, you see. And then nobody can travel or solicit funds or recruit or do anything at all to help you out. And the airlines will be blocked from transporting you. And this is a global crackdown, global bureaucracy, global police state, actually, is coming now. Now, the police did not bother me because I was in a unitary state. They couldn't confiscate me because I was in a unified oneness. And so I was just observing. I was just observing what was happening. They tried to harass me, and they could not. They said, "Okay, we're going to go after these others." Remember, this world is nothing but an expression of your continuity fear. It's an outward expression of an inward condition. That's it. And again, this is a weed whacker that just starts up. I try to tape. This is what's going to be happening. They're going to be whacking all the weeds. What they feel are the weeds of this world are going to be whacked. I did see that the police going after that person was dressed all in white as a white person. And they were very defiant of the police. And the police, I was very surprised. There's at a party. There's all these other nationalities and ethnicities there. It's only the white person that the police went after. And went after them with tremendous aggression. I was really stunned. I thought, you don't have a chance to bother them. And they did. They were tremendously aggressive. So it's probably a global police force, United Nations police force, is going to be utilized in all this, dealing with the UN resolutions. And clearly, in prophecy, we're told when the President of the United States chairs the Security Council at a certain Feast of Trumpets, this particular president like this, this is the beginning of this global one world, new world order, global dictatorship, global police force. And this is what they've been aiming for all along, actually. That's why I've been through this tremendous sense of urgency. Now, another sign is that my work is being cut out from my work. Suddenly, they're not calling me. I'm not getting anything. It's like, wow, okay, that's finished. Right on cue, September 24th, 2014. Now, the unitary state which protects you comes from the evaporation of your continuity fear. Now, the question is, are there ways and means to evaporate this continuity fear? Answer is yes. I've done it. Not difficult. It does take time. You have to work at it every day. That's all. Work at it every day. There's a lot of people get up in the morning, play golf every day, retired people every day. There's a lot of people get up and go to work every day. Most people, right? There's a lot of people do everything, something every day. They get up and do something. All you have to do is get up every day and dedicate that day to evaporating your continuity fear. That's it. And then the exercises are simple. So the question is, do we have to remain in harm's way? The answer is probably not. What people are worried about is they may be in a place that is too nice for them, a situation that they say, "Why? I don't think I could stay here." Well, if you just work on evaporating your continuity fear, you certainly can. You certainly can. For example, Jesus, in a dream, I met Jesus and he invited me to his house. Say, "Hey, would you like to come over and see my house?" And I said, sure. I was very enthusiastic. Well, most people would say, they think, "Oh my gosh, am I ready for this? Am I worthy of this?" You see, those things would like say, "Well, maybe a little later. Is it okay if I come a little later?" Jesus says, sure, a little later. I said, "Yeah, let's go right now. Right now, let's do it. I'd love to." So it's like there was no fear at all in me about that. This comes from working every day. It's every day working on your continuity problem. Not dogma. Okay, doesn't mean you accept the dogma and then just wait. Okay, I'm going to die. When I die, I'm going to go to heaven. Okay, that's dogma. You're just waiting for dogma to happen. And when you wait for dogma, you get Big Mother, actually, it descends upon this world as it is now. So it's not about accepting a dogma and waiting. It is about doing spiritual practices with intensity and experiencing the indignation and the burn within you, like, wow. You know, this, I thought I had the answers and I don't. Oh, I'm so indignant, you know, like that. Oh, it, but gradually you lose the fear. So when Jesus says, "Would you like to come to my place?" And we say, "Of course, let's go right now." Because I know that the Holy Spirit has exercises and practices for us, that whatever situation we're in, we'll be able to adjust to it, be able to adjust to it. Simply, easily. Simple practices. These practices are not some esoteric rituals or nothing. No, I just say, "I confess I have a severe continuity fear. It's the only problem that I have. I don't have a world crisis problem." See, world crisis problem doesn't exist. Only the continuity problem exists. World crisis problem has absolutely no value for me. only the vision of oneness has value for me. So when you make the vision of oneness your goal and you realize the only problem you have is the fear of the vision of oneness, that's it. You fear that it's too good for you. Okay. That is the only problem we have. We fear that reality is too good for us. So what we do is we gradually wear away that this misconception. You see, if Jesus asked you to visit his house, you think, oh, that's too good for me. I'm not ready for that. That's how we feel. I said, yeah, of course. I'd love to see it. Love to see it. Knowing that it's an opportunity to, get used to reality, which is our home. We just tried to turn our backs on it, and what we do is we're just dreaming. It's like we're sitting, the prodigal son story, the prodigal son comes home and God welcomes him home, it's all happy, but eventually the prodigal son wakes up and realizes, oh my gosh, I was only dreaming the whole thing. There isn't any place other than the Father's kingdom. There is no other place than the I am-ness. So, going to a place, for instance, that Jesus is home, for example. Well, what would you do? What would I do? I'd say, well, you have a practice for me here, so I can start practicing this, and start getting in tune. Start moving my comfort zone. There's something I can focus my attention on here, and like that. Now, of course, we've been doing these exercises, of course, to set ourselves up for a better situation. That is for sure. This world is about to get very wild. That's all these wildcats. There's a little fly buzzing around here. All these wildcats were coming in, and I was like, oh my gosh, hissing and, claws. And, there's this very feral, attitude is coming to this world. I've noticed that the people I see, it's like they're very feral, like animals. You can see that among the women. They express themselves outwardly a lot more than men. Men are much more stoic. But women are dressing and expressing and, body language and all this. And you can see, it's like, holy cow, they're like an animal, like a cat or something. Whereas in the past, you see a lot of women, the way they express themselves was very much working to transcend the flesh, to let go of this false belief of flesh, and trying not to be animalistic, trying to be repentant. The whole body language, the whole way of expressing was very different. Very respectful, very modest. They're making the efforts. Nowadays, what's coming in the world, they're not making any efforts. They are totally into being animalistic. And you get this from all sides now in this world. And that is no bueno, no good whatsoever. We've worked too hard. We've worked to such a great extent to get free of this, to free ourselves of this way of functioning, free ourselves of the flesh. We want to identify with spirit. Want to identify with spirit. We are spirit. We're not flesh. Flesh is just a silly idea that spirit said, hey, I wonder if I could become flesh. No, it cannot. But it can believe that it can, but it can't actually. So there is some tremendous urgency right now in the world. I would say this resolution that is likely to be pushed through is going to produce a global sanctioning body now. And the ultimate aim is to eventually put the whole world under these global laws that they'll put the apparatus in place. And then later that apparatus will be used to suppress truth, suppress religion, suppress those who think differently than the bureaucracy, etc., etc., etc. Okay. So we've reached this tipping point. This is the day, the 24th of September is that tipping point. And that's that balloon of Jesus above Melbourne. I have 24 on it. And I was trying to figure out, what is it, the 24? What parallels the 24? And I did tie it into extremist activity in some way. Somehow it was connected to extremist activity. I thought there may be some explosions or something. There may be. I mean, ISIS may retaliate in some way. I don't know. But the date is that I didn't know it was the Feast of Trumpets. I didn't know the Security Council was taking place. But now you're looking in hindsight and say, oh my God, this is the Security Council passing this global resolution on the Feast of Trumpets, Jewish holiday, which is very important. Many believe that Jesus will return on the Feast of Trumpets. So it could very well be that the presence of I Am-ness, which is what people call Jesus, the universal, omnipresent I Am-ness, may begin calling us, may begin pulling us, starting September 24th, because these flies are very going to increase. The animalistic nature of this world is about to increase. To a tremendous extent, you can hear the noise here. And the fears of the conspiracy people are certainly well-founded, actually. In this dream, looking what's going to happen to the world, I said, wow, yeah. They're certainly, their concerns are well-founded. The answer is to evaporate your own continuity of fear. Otherwise, you will simply project that outward and feel you need to conflict and defeat something. Whereas if you evaporate your continuity of fear, you don't feel you need to defeat anything. You simply feel that you want to go somewhere that's really, really wonderful, where there aren't any problems that need to be defeated. All right? You don't feel any need to defeat anything. Because the continuity fear has been recognized instead of projected outward and disassociated from. And then you see it as an enemy out there that you need to defeat, thinking that will... But defeating a projection out there doesn't get to the root of it. The fear is still there and you just project out more. So it's an endless task. It's a Sisyphean task of rolling a stone up the mountain and it rolls back down. This is projection. You project this continuity fear outward to an external form. You see what's happening in the world. Is this intent, right? Here it comes. Here comes the weed whacking. Then you work and fight and slay this form out there. And you think, oh, I'm saved. Continuity fear is still very powerful, has done nothing to solve it, resolve it, evaporate. And then you project again. Oh, well, there's another enemy. And you whack them. And then there's another one. You whack them. It never ends. It never ends. That's why I say this, the world's on the wrong path of defeating enemies instead of evaporating their own inner continuity fear. Once you evaporate the continuity fear, there's no projection. So you don't project any enemies at all. You don't even project a world that's problematic. There's no need to. No need to whatsoever. You're no longer afraid of relaxing into the totality. This world truly is a world of misery, the projection, a world of projection, the projected world, an expression of continuity fear, is a ceaseless, endless task of conquering, overcoming, conquering, externally, your projections, and nothing. If anything, the continuity problem gets worse as we do this. So, you know, what people are afraid of, if they don't have this world, how can I succeed? You don't need this world to succeed. If you are able to work on your continuity, if you're evaporating it for yourself through these exercises, you don't need a problematic world at all. You're not trying to conquer anything out there. You know it's all within you. But for those who don't see this, they see a world, there's no problems. They say, well, how can I ever succeed? I've got to slay the dragons. I've got to defeat the enemy here. Where's the enemy? I don't see the enemy. See, this is the problem. So that is why getting on the spiritual path and working, getting to the point where you can do exercises is all important, actually. Always tell yourself that. Yeah, rhetoric is great, but doing the exercises is what really matters. It's not dealing with something external. It's within you. There's nobody I have to reconcile with. I simply have to overcome my fear, evaporate my continuity fear, so I'm no longer afraid of reality. So I no longer say, well, reality's too good for me. Or at least we go a long ways toward that. See, our continuity fear again is the belief that reality is too good for us. We don't deserve it. We're not able to function there. It's only for those who are pure. We can't function there. We'll be terrible. It's too good for us. No, we don't want it. We don't want it. That's continuity fear. I've gone to some very, very beautiful places in this world, and I tried to get other people to go there. They wouldn't go there. I said, why don't you just look at it? No, it's terrible there. No, it's not there. There couldn't be anything there. I said, well, here's some pictures. Look at this thing. They won't look at it. They won't evaluate it. They say, it's too good for me. It's too good for me, is what they're saying. So you can just hear the intensity going on, you know, around me right now, right? And the flies and the intensity of it all. So here it comes. Reality is not too good for us. In fact, we have no choice. We never left reality. You can't leave reality. So we're just like trying to pretend we're comatose. And we're afraid to wake up. You know, it's too good for me. It's too good for me. It's too good for me. But we can gradually get used to it. And that's the whole point of the situation. That's what we're trying to do. That's what we're doing. We gradually get used to something better. It's really better. So much better. And we lose our fear. We feel like, yeah, I do deserve it. I could function there. I believe I could function. And so we turn this whole continuity fear around. One more time, the continuity fear is we think reality is just too good for us. There's no way that we deserve it. We can function there. It's just too good for us. That's the continuity fear in a nutshell. We have no choice but to overcome this fear. And we have to do it gradually by evaporating the fear bit by bit by bit by bit by bit. This is the task. Otherwise, you're going to be Sisyphus rolling a stone up a hill, the stone of your projections, and that stone will just keep rolling right back to you, and you push it up again, it rolls back to you, and the projections always come back. The ideas don't leave their source, and so the idea of fear that the reality is too good for me, projected out there as an enemy I can defeat, it's still with you, project again. Endless cycles that way. Endless cycles. We get out of those endless cycles, break the cycles of projection by owning the situation, admitting I have a severe continuity problem, and then working on it using the practices that which we've been doing, simple practices. See, they're revving up their motors, aren't they? Yeah. They are getting ready to do some serious whacking. There's no question about it. This is what I saw in the dream. Seriously aggressive action is going to take place. Will take place. So I don't know how we can be any more simple and plain about it. serious stuff, right? Serious wacky. So, it's go time. It is go time. It is go time. And don't worry if you say, well, I this could be difficult. That's fine. That's fine. Some of us have done this for a long enough time that it doesn't feel like such a problem. But we understand in hindsight that it's just a matter of everyday application and working at it. And it works. It works. It works. So it's not that difficult to be dedicated to something. If you realize you have to do it, you have no choice, you say, okay, and you say, I'm just going to do it. I'm just going to do it. That's all. So we will see what go time means for us now. We will see what go time means for us. And a little lull here. Maybe that means some quiet, right? Okay. Yeah. Not sure what is next. Okay, really. But should be a great opportunity for everyone. And I hope we walk the last mile together. The last mile is the space for actually practicing. That's all it is. So that's all it is. And you say, well, that's not so bad. That's kind of easy. Yeah. Give up all vulnerability. Give up all safety. Abandon all vulnerability and all safety and relax into that. Relax into that. You say, oh. But when we say that, there's this, like, sort of slight disorientation is all, right? Like, whoa. So you just let that slight disorientation be there. I remember when I went to some place that was really beautiful, I was really scared going there. I said, I can't handle this. I'm going to die. And I was so nervous. And I got through it. I said, wow, that was incredible. I just loved it. I didn't die. It was just so beautiful. And then the next time I went, it was hardly any problem at all. I just like loved it. And so it is. You feel this sense of disorientation. What you have to do is just stay in this full stop mode and don't struggle with it. Just say, okay, that's great. Some disorientation, that means I'm moving into something better. Okay, that's good. Just move normally. Just stay in a normal mode. But you won't be excelling. You see, you won't be excelling. When you're in a slight disorientation, moving into something better, you will not be in an excelling mode. Okay, and that's what bothers people. They say, well, how can I be a superstar in the world if I'm doing these exercises? Well, you can't. You cannot. Who wants to be a superstar in this world, though? Think about that. Been there, done that. Terrible. People, what happens is that the animalistic nature of the world comes at you. You know, give me some food. Give me some food. They're snarling at you like that. So, sure, you won't be a superstar. That's okay. Just like I went to this place, this golf course, so beautiful. I was so intimidated. It's like so disordered. Like, wow, I'm sort of overwhelmed or slight. Disorientation. So I didn't play very well. It didn't matter. Because I was just like looking at this place and just saying, I love this place. And I was just feeling this tremendous feeling of love and peace. Just I just love it. Gratitude. It was just emotional. Golf really didn't matter. I just knocked it around and it was fine. Not a problem. So of course you will not excel at worldly endeavors when you're doing this. But that, who cares? What you're doing is you're preparing yourself for something way better than this world. Way better. This world is becoming a nasty, nasty place. A very animalistic place. A pseudo-intellect masking the animalness of it all. Now, we don't have to be perfect to step up to do this, okay? You don't have to be perfect to start out. The whole idea is you got a severe continuity problem. So obviously, we're afraid of perfection. You think, I can't function this perfect. What, how's that possible? Gradually is how it's possible. A mighty river didn't just appear. A lot of rain came down for that mighty river to be there, right? So when this feeling of sort of like, wow, this is maybe a little bit overwhelming, or I'm not sure if I can handle this. This is slightly disoriented. This is so wonderful. Just full stop in that, and just practice that every day. Just practice it during the day, all the time, as much as you can. That's all I've ever done, really. It's just do that and just practice it. It just takes will. Say, okay, wow, I'm just going to be humble and meek here. I'm really feeling like this is really stunning. Yeah, this good news is very stunning. So I cannot really be a function well in this world as far as being a real superstar at all. So that's fine, not a problem. Just take that, be humble, be meek, be repentant. I have a severe problem. I'm getting over it. I'm gradually awakening to the inherent greatness of reality, the inherent greatness of it all. And we are all that. And that's it for this video.